Hi, it's Greg Baird from northernvoice.com and meepers.com. It's great to see you. Glad you're checking in with me today. And you know what? Today is a great day. It's a beautiful day outside. Can't really tell because you're in my apartment with me. But I'm heading out shortly to go to Little Street Art Center located right here in Chicago. It's on the corner of Ravenswood and Montrose. It's a fascinating place. It's a place where artists can take classes, the kids can take classes. You can learn about art and also buy art if you want to buy some pottery and different things there. They also have a great little cafe. Well, anyway, we are going to talk to my friend Norbert White, and Norbert is a potter, and he does an awesome job in his craft. And then after that, we're going to travel to his home and check out the home he shares with his partner, Teddy Greenwood, and what a fascinating place this is. And you'll find out about all that in just a few minutes. So come along with me today. It's going to be a really great time.
Have to have a kind of nurturing environment to be in. I can't be around a lot of angry people, and that's why I like the class so much. You know, they're just so centered and amazing.
Why don't you tell me a little bit about your class, why you like it so much?
Well, because these are, you know, women that have really experienced, primarily women, that have really experienced a lot in life, you know. Many of them have been through maybe motherhood, they've maybe been through marriage, maybe they've been through divorce, maybe, you know, they have had children, and dealt with, you know, all of those things along the way, and you know, some dealt with like serious illnesses as well. And so I think my goal, one of my goals in life, because all of that stuff comes around to all of us at some point, and I want to be around some models that are resilient enough to go through that and still come out on the other side being vibrant, creative, funny. And that's what these people are in the class. I mean, we aren't here as much that we are... I mean, each of us is on our own path artistically, whether it's a hobby, whether we're seeking... Well, I think we all seek a form of expression. But certainly, you know, we all have different styles, different things we like to do, different things we get out of the class. And one of the biggest rewards is definitely the friendships that get forged here.
Hello, my name is Norbert White. Welcome to our home. I'm a partner with Ted Greenwood, and I do pottery and mosaic work. My pottery can be found at the Lee Gallery on Halstead and Aldine. Also, you can find me online at www.norbertwhite.com. N-O-R-B-E-R-T-W-H-I-T-E. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoy the tour.
Yeah, Norbert, why don't you tell me about your pieces here that are right below us.
These are two fairly simple tables. We needed tables out here. You could probably drop them off the building and they wouldn't break. They're, you know, pretty heavy duty. The top is a mosaic. The blue tile is Mexican ceramic tile. There's lots of bits of dichroic glass, stone, beads, mirror, and other shards of pottery that I've done that, for whatever reason, I've chosen to break. So it was a lot of fun working on a little larger scale. The carving on the side, I found very freeing to, you know, be able to make such bold strokes with the tool. And it's interesting, as I was talking to a person, a woman in the studio, came up while I was carving them, so I feel like my conversation with her is carved. And it really was cemented in that moment, you know, where we were talking about her and things going on in her life, that it was really beautiful. This is the mating call in Uptown, basically. So this is a piece that I did. It's obviously a platter, kind of a display piece largely. It can also hang on the wall. The colors I derived from a photo from a book called Extraordinary Pheasants. And there is a bird called a Chinese monal. I believe that's the correct pronunciation. Anyway, he has all of these amazing colors in his feathers. And I was so just enamored with this one photo that I just couldn't stand it. So I did actually about five pieces with all these different types of glass on it. This piece here is a cake plate that I made during a recent class. I obviously am very much in love with deep, intense blues and greens. And so this was really a joy making that. And even though I don't really bake cake, we have it. It's a fun display piece, and we definitely enjoy having it around. The piece next to it I made at the same time. It was made last fall. This is called Sgraffito, and basically you take a porcelain bowl that I threw, and you paint it black, and then you scrape away the design. So what's interesting about this piece, it was a mythology and dreams class. So I asked Ted to help me out. I said, I don't draw, so we need to, I want to make something cool. So what he helped me with was he pulled out an art book, and it was one of our zodiac books, and we had the story of his sign and my sign in a Native American tradition. My sign is the wolf and his sign is the crow, so I kind of threw those images on there and have really enjoyed doing Sgraffito ever since then. So that's kind of one of my new focuses.
And it's a really unique piece because both of you, you know, you had that connection with Ted.
Yes.
Your partner over here is Ted. Mm-hmm. And you have that connection with, you know, a piece of artwork that you're creating and the bowl and just that good energy in it. I mean,
It's wonderful. It's fun because the wolf, I think one of the things you think about with a wolf is, you know, howling at the moon. And so to me, it obviously appeared to be a night scene. Ted, I often ask him for ideas. He's like a salad shooter with ideas. And then I'll tell him to stop, you know. But it's kind of like he likens it to throwing spaghetti against the wall and you wait for something to stick. So when I asked him, I was like, you know, I just want it to look cool. Can we do something that I can do that will look good?
So Norbert and Teddy, you're showing me your place, and we came across this incredible painting down your changing room, and I'm quite fixated by it. It's also quite hot. But why don't you tell me about that? I'm really impressed. It's really awesome.
Well, Ted, this is something that he painted. It's something that he had felt, a photograph that he felt very strong about, so I'll let him explain it to you.
I was looking for something to put in our hallway, actually, a piece that would kind of celebrate that chakra center of sexuality and, you know, mastering your sexuality, and it's also a means of kind of symbolically embracing or welcoming people into the space. Now, whether or not you would know that or not, or
right,
perceive that, is not important. But for us, it would give that sense of inclusion and liberty and all that.